know that we are going to continue overcoming in Jesus' name. Okay, let us look at another point. Second point is failure to be rooted in God's word that has been received with joy. Praise the Lord. So if you are not rooted in the word of God, for example, you have heard the gospel of God, you have heard the word of God, you have been taught of what to do, but when you don't get rooted into that very word, what does it mean? That you plant yourself in this very word. You desire to walk in it, live in it, meditate upon it, become it. Praise the Lord. When you don't do that, when you don't desire to become the word of God or be in his word all the time, doing his word, then definitely you will fall into temptation. I'm going to be reading a scripture which is in the book of Luke chapter 8, 13. Let us go there. Luke 8, 13. Praise the Lord so much. I believe we are going to overcome together, because every point that I make, in fact, there is what we call provision of how you can overcome that very temptation. Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay, Luke 8:13. What does it say? It says, "They on the rock are they which, when they hear, receive the word with joy, and these have no root, which for a while believe, and in time of temptation fall away." So yeah, these ones, they just hear the word of God with the joy, and they don't get rooted in that, and when temptation come, then they just fall away. Why? Because they are not rooted. Yes, they received the word, but they did not enjoy to live in that very word. They did not even mind about working out that very word, because there is a scripture which says in the book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 24 to 25. I want us to go there, King James Version, and I believe you are going to be blessed in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm very pleased today that we are going to have more scriptures and we crush the devil by the word of God. Praise the Lord so much. Okay, Matthew 7, 24 to 25. "Therefore, whosoever heareth these things of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock." Let me read up to 27. "And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine, and doeth them not, shall be likened unto a foolish man, which built his house upon the sand. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon the house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it." Praise the Lord so much. So when you look at this, that when you hear the word of God and you put it in action, when you hear the word of God and start to practice it and start walking it, definitely you'll be very strong in that very word. You'll be likened unto this very wise man who built his house on the rock. And when what? And when the floods, when the winds blew, when rain fell, it did not fall. Why? Because it was built on the rock. So when you put yourself in the word of God and for it, you will be able to overcome temptations. And you remember, even when the devil came tempting Jesus Christ, the reason why he overcame the devil is because of the word of God that he had in him. Praise the Lord. In fact, he was the word himself in the flesh. Praise the Lord so much. So because of the word, he overcame the devil. And I want to thank God that we are going to overcome the devil by the word of God. So if you don't want to fall into temptations, just keep yourself in the word of God. Let us use this very approach that Jesus used in the wilderness when he was tempted by the devil. When you go in the book of Matthew chapter 4 from verse 1 up to 8, you definitely see what I'm talking about. Praise the Lord so much. So today I want us to be so strong in the word of God. I want us to keep ourselves in the word of God and be able to overcome in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord so much. Okay. The third point is this: failure to die to flesh and its lusts. So when you fail to die to flesh and its lusts, if you're still yearning the things of the flesh, you're still walking at the command of the flesh and its lusts, definitely you fall away. You will fall into temptation. Praise the Lord. That's why it is very important for a person to understand that by overcoming the flesh and its lusts, definitely you are going to overcome.